key challenge that we are having, that we are trying to overcome, is that the city alone, the public sector alone, doesn't have enough resources to invest, to finance the transition toward climate neutral cities. Although usually the financial return that you generate with those investments isn't enough to sustain an attractive investment, there is additional returns, additional benefits associated with these. So you have ecological returns in cleaner air, in reduced carbon emissions. You may have social returns on invest in a more equitable society, and you have wider economic returns that could, for example, lead to a higher degree of innovation and new businesses coming out.
We need to find ways to invest in alternative modes of service provision and infrastructure. This looks like new technologies, but new technologies that are embedded in local context.
Majority of the investments is still going to very exclusive few. When we talk of the bottom of the pyramid, that's very, very less investments are going in. They are only going to places where the capital markets are robust, where their financial returns are secured.
I'm seeing that there is at this very moment no one coherent impact assessment framework that could be applied to any situation. Particularly when it comes to investments in cities, we have this situation where you achieve some very direct impacts, right? But you also achieve a variety of sort of secondary impacts, which are already a bit harder to describe.
Currently, I completely agree that impact measurement, first of all, is difficult to measure. Second is, even if you can measure, it's not always comparable to different companies, different regions. It's very regional, contextual as well.